In this video, I'm going to show you how to create sheet tabs from a list in Excel. And from there, I'm going to show you how to create a table of contents with hyperlinks so you can jump to that sheet in your workbook. Let's take a look. All right, here we have a list in Excel, and this is our list of all of the sheets that we want to have listed out down here in our Excel workbook. So without using VBA code, we are going to do this using pivot tables, and I'll show you how this works. So first, what we want to do is go ahead and click on insert, and we're going to insert a pivot table from a table or range. It's going to select our range of data. And we can say in the existing worksheet, and we'll just pick a cell to place this pivot table. We're going to end up deleting this later, so it doesn't matter where you put it. I'm going to click OK. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring down the header here into the filters area. So now we have a filter set up here on our pivot table. We're going to go up to the pivot table analyze tab, and then over here under pivot table name, we have a drop down for options. Go ahead and click on show report filter pages, and it's going to highlight your index here and then say okay. And notice that all of these sheet tabs got automatically generated. Now the only issue here is it will put all of those sheet tabs in alphabetical order. And so if you had a different order that you wanted these to be in, you're going to want to reorder them. So on sheet one, which is where we had the original, it's already at the end of your list. I'm going to drag that back up here. And then notice that we want our master sheet table of contents to be the first sheet. So I'm going to drag that one back over here. And then we want to have our income and expenses, so I'm going to drag that. Then our bank transactions, then our savings, then our report categories, or sorry, reporting, and then report categories. So now we have our sheets back in the right order. And then the other thing, when we did this, it generated a pivot table on each of the tabs. So to get rid of that, what we're going to do is select the first tab here, and then hold your shift key and select the last tab. So if you have quite a few tabs, you can use your arrow buttons, but I'm just going to hold the shift key and select my last tab that selects all of the tabs. Then I'm going to highlight the two columns where the pivot table filter exists. I'm going to right click and clear contents. So doing that on one of the sheets applies that action to all of the selected tabs. So now none of them have that pivot table there. We can now go back to our main sheet here, and we can delete the pivot table. We don't need that. We were just using that so it would generate all of the tabs for us, so we didn't have to manually do that. So I'm going to right click and delete those. So we want our master sheet table of contents to be the sheet. We don't really need a sheet one, so I'm just going to copy the data from that and place it over here. I'm going to double click to format that, and now we can actually delete sheet one. And so now we have our list of all of our sheets and our list here that we want to add hyperlinks. Now what we want to do is create a column with our hyperlinks. So I'm going to say link to tab and hit enter. And let's make this a table. We're going to go to insert and just anywhere in the table, I'm just going to hit control T and mark that your table has headers and click OK. This turns our data into a table, and we're going to format this. We can take off the formatting and then make sure we can go home here, and let's take out the fill and any borders. All right, then we can apply whatever formatting we want to later on in our table. So I'm going to bold and center these and pick a color for that. All right, here is where I'm going to insert a formula for the hyperlink. And so what I'm going to do is copy this, and this will be in the description below the video. So all you have to do is copy and paste this. I'm going to paste this in here, and then up here I'm going to hit equals so that Excel recognizes that this is a formula. And what this is going to create a hyperlink. The hashtag symbol there stands for so that we don't have to type the name of the existing workbook. It's just referencing that we want to pull this information out of the current workbook that we have open. And it's going to pull the name of the master sheet table of contents over here and list that as the label for the hyperlink. And so I'm going to just place my cursor at the end and hit enter. And then that fills all the way down. And notice that now we have hyperlinks to all of the different tabs in our workbook. And so if we click on any of these, it will jump to that respective tab in our workbook. Then if we want to create a link back to the master sheet table of contents on all of the other tabs, we can click on our tab, select the cell where we want to place the link back to the table of contents, go up to insert link, click on a place in this document, and click on the master sheet table of contents. Up here, we can call it whatever we want. If we want to label it TOC for table of contents, and then click OK. It automatically inserts a hyperlink, and you can reformat this however you need to. But now when you click on that, it'll link back to this main table of contents sheet. So then all you have to do is go to that tab where you created it, copy the cell, and then paste it into each of the other tabs where you want that to be located. And now you can jump back to your main table of contents from any of the tabs in your workbook. Be sure and share this video with your friends if you found it helpful and give it a thumbs up to like it. You can subscribe to my channel and click the bell to receive a notification when I post new videos. Visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.